I really prefer to spray it when I put a bolt back or a nut back. Just spray it with the penetrating oil on the threads. It's not going to affect the torque because it's not an oil basically, but it will keep these things from happening. It will prevent rust happening on the threads and basically locking the nut in there. That was really, really tough to undo. And you are always scared that you will slip the T40 by forcing too much on it. That's why it's really important not to keep it on the side, but really, really straight on the stud, on the same line with the stud, and use a quality one. But this is the idea. This is one scary bolt on this car. I would say it's the scariest. Perhaps the ball joint also, but so right now I'm looking to be careful that the butt is rotating, is not catching, so it's not yet torn. Because I'm going to use the end link. It's in good condition. And when you undo these end links, I really prefer to to lift off both front wells, because maybe I will do an example. When you just put everything back in place and you need to, you notice the torsion bar, sway bar, anti-roll bar has a pressure on it, and I do prefer, let me see if the camera is showing this. I do prefer to get a with both front wells off the ground. It's less tension on the sway bar, and I prefer to introduce this cheater bar or pry bar in between. This is the anti-roll bar and this is the subframe, in between them, and just push downwards to release the pressure, and this way you can place this guy or remove it very, very easily. Just toss it, twist a little bit the small bond joint and it comes out, and when you place it back, you notice how it stays up. You just let me see, the camera will show, basically just depress down in between the anti-roll bar, sway bar, and the subframe, and just bring this guy back to match it with the hole. Otherwise, you won't make it, basically. All right, thanks for watching. I'm really tired. Still working on this thing.